is scale construction for reflective constructs. Formative constructs are actually not that so what makes sense for scale construction are reflective constructs rather than formative constructs. Okay, so what is the idea of measurement error? So as I just as I mentioned, x is the observed score on the item, true is the latent factor, and E is the measurement error, right? Remember the model of the reflective indicator that we had. This was a reflective indicator, right? And this was it. And we had written this equation. So this is called as the measurement equation, right? This is the measurement equation. So you have the item, observed item by one, which is loading times the latent factor plus E1, right? So that is what we are writing here. X is the true observed value for person I from an operationalization of a construct, that is a test score. So basically you get it from an item, and T is the person's true score on the construct, and E is the measurement error, and T, variable T, is the latent variable. It is the factor that we are looking at, an unobservable variable that is measured by variable. So this is the unobservable. This is the latent factor that is measured by the observed item. Now there are two kinds of measurement errors. Just before the break, someone asked me about consistent and inconsistent measurement errors. So what I call them as, instead of consistent and inconsistent, I find this terminology to be more helpful: random errors and systematic errors. What are random errors? Random errors are errors of measurement. Okay, they are errors of measurement which are different for different people and different for different items. So there mean that means just think of standing on a weighing machine again and again. Let's say the true score is 70 kgs. You stand on the weighing machine, you get a reading of 71. Next time you stand on the machine, you get a reading of 72. Next time you stand on the machine, you get a reading of 67. Again, you stand on the machine, you now get 69. And you stand on the machine again, you get 71. Whereas the true score, was 70, and your observed scores are 71, 72, and so on. Now there, if you see, this is random. There is no systematic pattern. These are inconsistent error. That means if you measured this score by 5 items, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, through 5 times, on some you get more, on some you get less, on some you get again less, on some you get again less, and then you get, right? So first of all, we don't know the true score. This is unknown, right? This is unknown. We don't know what it is. We are trying to estimate the true using the observed items, right? So the true score, Bharat is asking, what is the true score? The true score is, well, the actual construct. Well, nobody has seen it, the actual intelligence, nobody knows it. But we now can observe the readings on the 5 items. So random errors are all over the place. So these are caused usually because of poor wordings of items and improper statements that we write in the scale. So for example, if I were to ask this question to all 115 of you, that your attending this FDP, okay, is a and double quotes serendipity, right? And this is my question. Okay, now this is serendipity. What does it mean? If somebody knows the meaning of serendipity, you can answer it in one way. Serendipity is by accident, by chance, right? So that means you are attending this FDP by chance, by accident. Okay, now that means it is not a, maybe it is not a good happening, it is a good happening, whatever. Somebody will answer to this because you have used this word. Somebody will answer it in good, high. Somebody may actually answer it as low, because I don't understand the meaning of serendipity. Somebody can again answer. So you are getting in your responses, you are getting your responses in a very random manner. There is no systematic pattern. These are inconsistent error. Everybody is going to respond in a different manner. Somebody, remember about test condition. Let's say you administer your survey to some participants in an air-conditioned room. Very nice, comfortable. And somebody is you give the survey who is sitting under a tree on a hot sunny day outside under a tree, and he or she is going to fill that response, that survey. Now this is going to be, again, one person is in a cold room, another person is sweating while filling your survey. So the kind of errors, that the kind of responses that you are going to get on your items is going to be very, very random. There is no pattern. And what is the quality of randomness? Randomness always, what I have written, always attenuates relationships, right? If you have correlation between random series is equal to a big zero. If you have two pure random series and you correlate them, the correlation is nothing but zero, right? So if you have randomness in your items, in the responses on your items, okay, then the kind of correlation you will get, okay, is going to be zero. That means you will not see any inter-item consistency. So that is one kind of error, right? So they are random errors, can be generic or idiosyncratic, okay? And let me now also talk about systematic. So let us go and, what is a systematic error? Now, if I ask you another question, I do my work well. This is a question, right? My question, next question, one was attending the FDP serendipity, and the second question is, I do my work well. What is going to be your response? Majority of us are going to say, agree or strongly, right? There would be very few people who will say, I do not do my work well, right? Now, if you keep on doing this again and again, right, you will always see that there is a high response to this item, and this is going to be an example of systematic error, right? So there, this is what we call as social desirability. Social desirability, right? We are socially desirable. Now, when you have social desirability, what will happen to correlations? Correlation R can actually go up, it can go down, or it can remain unchanged. Whereas in correlation and randomness, it will always go, down, because if you are, if you have systematic bias, I do my work well, that is one item. And then you also have an item that I am motivated person. And then you have a performance item, I do my work well. What do you think will be the correlation? The correlation is going to be high. I am motivated and I also do my work well. You are going to respond high on both these questions. And therefore your correlations can go up. Your correlations can also go down again if you have another kind, or they actually may remain even unchanged. So I don't really know what will happen with systematic errors. Systematic errors can reduce correlations, can increase correlations, may change, may let them remain unchanged, but in randomness it will always go, right? So when we talk about measures and creating valid measures, right, we are trying to talk about whether the measure is accurate, and therefore we talk about whether the measure is free of random and systematic errors. But systematic errors may not change or may do anything to the correlation. But for randomness, I know that it will definitely reduce my correlation. So what I want to tell here is that by testing all these kinds of reliability, doing reliability testing, factor analysis, and all of that, it is a sure way to check for randomness. Reliability, factor analysis, all of that, they can check random errors for sure. Systematic errors need much more thought through and careful development of your scales, your items, and so on. So, but at least randomness can be easily checked using reliability testing. Majorly by reliability testing, we tend to rule out that there is any random error. And I'll talk about how do we do that in